In this illustration, we'll be calculating the torque of viscous forces on a disc. The figure shows a disc D of diameter small d connected to an axle placed on a fixed horizontal surface. And a sink, there exists a thin layer of a lubricant of viscosity eta between disc and ground of thickness T. We are required to find the external torque required to rotate the disc at a uniform angular velocity omega. Here, to analyze the torque acting on the disc that must be equal to the torque of viscous forces acting on disc, then only it can rotate at uniform angular speed omega. Now, if we just have a look on the disc, if the disc is rotating at a uniform angular speed omega, then in this situation, here to analyze the viscous forces, we can consider an elemental strip over here on the disc, which is of width dx and radius x. If it is rotating at an angular speed omega, the velocity of this strip will be v. So, the lubricant which is below this strip would also be moving with the velocity v, which is in contact with the disc, and the lubricant which is in contact with the ground will be at rest. So, here we can calculate first that if we consider an elemental ring on disc, as shown, the speed of particles of lubricant just below this element is, if we calculate the speed, that will be equals to x omega. And we know the particles of lubricant which are in contact with ground, these are at rest. So, we can calculate the velocity gradient in lubricant below this element is, this we can write as dv by dx, and that should be written as x omega divided by t, as t is the thickness of the lubricant layer. So, we can calculate the viscous force on element which will be acting tangentially is, this viscous force we can write as df, which is eta a dv by dx. So, it is eta, the area of this strip we can write as 2 pi x dx multiplied by the velocity gradient, which is x omega by t. So, in this situation, if this is the viscous force, we can now calculate the torque of viscous force on element is d tau, that can be written as df multiplied by x, and this will be given as 2 pi eta omega by t multiplied by x cube dx. So, if we calculate the total torque on disc, here, if we talk about external torque, this must be equals to torque due to viscous forces, that is integration of d tau. To maintain the constant angular speed omega, the external torque must be equal to the torque of viscous forces. So, this will be integration of, here it is 2 pi eta omega by t, integration of x cube dx, and we integrate it from 0 to, we are given that the disc D is of diameter small d, so we can integrate it from 0 to d by 2. because x will be integrated to the radius of this disk. And when we integrate this, it becomes x 4 by 4. So this 2 pi eta omega by t. And it will be x 4 by 4. And we put limits from 0 to d by 2. And when we substitute the limits, the final result we'll be getting here is pi eta omega d to power 4 divided by 32 t. That is the result of this problem.